his saying gave me fear. Because I carried out the broken phrase, perhaps to worse meaning than he had.
This question put I, and he answered me, seldom it comes to pass that one of us maketh the journey upon which I go.
That Lord who had led me thitherward said unto me, Fear not, because our passage none can take from us, it by such is given. But here await me in thy weary spirit, comfort and nourish with a better hope, for in this nether world I will not leave thee. So onward goes and there abandons me, my father's sweet, and I remain in doubt, for no and yes within my head content.
Yo, Callie, what are you saying over there?
I don't know, I'm just muttering something. Nothing really important.
This has been winter break. I'm living alone at my house. And it's been pretty nice. I was here about 3 weeks before everybody moved in over the summer. And there was a nice, you know, quiet air about it. And there's even more so now, obviously, because it's winter. It's like a ghost town. Besides the locals, there are very few students up here. I'm working a lot at the shop right up here. Thought I could get away from it, but it never does. I've gotten more hours now that school's been out. And I'm taking a week off so I can go home for Christmas and New Year's and all that. But when I come back, straight work. Gonna be doing nothing but work so I can save up money, you know, for this new semester because these bills are not gonna pay themselves. And Mark is actually up here as well.
God, my life is a fucking mess. I'm living here over winter break, trying to get my shit together, hopefully get a job to get back on my feet, but it's not really working out that well right now.
Mark is a gambling degenerate. When his parents stopped feeding him to obsession, he pawned his car, sold his Xbox, and when all that money went away, he started borrowing from his friends. When his friends stopped lending him money, he borrowed from loan sharks. When his loan sharks wanted the bills back, he fled Buffalo, his bullshit hometown, and he came here to live in Albany.
I'm close to paying everybody off. It's pretty tough, but it's a really good feeling. You know, I've been scheming my way into a lot of things, making some quick money here and there. But, you know, I'm starting to realize once everyone's paid off, I'm back to square one. I'm back at $0.
Fucker was supposed to get a job over this past semester. But instead of that, he was smoking and joking here at the Nest with Dan and Shay the entire time. And now, over the break, he's inhabiting it like a vagrant. A bum.
I mean, I know I fucked up, but I have Callie here living with me over break, trying to teach me how to get back on my feet, teaching me how to get a job, and I actually landed an interview with Johnny Rockets in the next couple of days, and, you know, hopefully that pans out.
Living with Mark has been pretty interesting. Seeing how the other half lives has been a learning experience, to say the least.
Callie and I need food, you got it. Natties and fatties, you got it. You learn how to survive out here when you've got nothing left.
Hey Callie, today I'm going to show you how to make a quick buck by robbing some cars.
Robbing cars?
Yep.
In broad daylight.
I don't see why not.
This is stupid.
I mean, sometimes in life you just got to cut corners.
How poetic. What if the car is locked?
Then I guess we just move on to the next one to avoid detection from loud noises.
Alright, you see, I brought this.
See why you would bring that.
I was thinking, instead of cutting quarters, we cut through some backyards.
No, that's stupid. Are you...
So I pull into work, almost hitting John as he stumbles across while I'm f***ing driving down the road. And I go to park my car, and I just see Ray sitting in his car, just staring at the building, smiling really creepily, kind of like this. So I'm just like, what the fuck? I go up to his window. It takes about 5 minutes for him to fucking put down the window. He couldn't figure it out. I don't know what was up. Until I found out that he's on acid. So John's gonna be drunk as usual. And Ray's gonna be on acid. I don't know how we're gonna handle John. I don't even know what to do. I'm the youngest fucking one here managing a bunch of old idiots.
It's pretty irresponsible of Ray to, you know, be on acid at work. I'm supposed to teach our guys life skills, virtues, like sharing. I want some fucking acid.
So I decided I'm gonna ticket. I'm gonna freeze my fucking hands off, but it has to be done because there's no way I'm letting some drunk asshole ticket or some guy tripping balls. Oddly enough though, they're gonna be the ones driving the cars. And the last car Ray took was a truck, and he looked kind of scared. It was so big.
This is great. This is so great.
What the f*** are you doing? What the f*** is this?
A car?
Did you just steal my f***ing car?
No, I borrowed it.
You know, I steal your car all the time, so this doesn't really upset me. But are you on fucking acid?
No.
You didn't get me any fucking acid? Are you fucking kidding me?
You didn't ask, okay? You're supposed to ask.
And what the fuck is this? You can't operate a fucking vehicle on drugs? Are you fucking kidding me? You think you're a world-class valet? Are you fucking serious right now? This is why you're not the fucking camera guy. You can't handle fucking mechanical shit. You got your head up your fucking ass. You didn't get me any fucking acid. Go yourself. Mother.
You want me to park it?
Mark and I make a pretty good duo. We cook here sometimes. We just made chicken and rice the other day. Came out pretty good. I'm quite the chef myself. What I'm really looking forward to is making meatballs. Ah, my grandmother's meatballs are to die for. She gave me the recipe, and they're splendid. I got 2 cards from my grandmother that I was supposed to send out on Thanksgiving and Christmas, and I never got to now, but I thought it'd be better later than never, so I'm sending them out tomorrow.
Who is this?
It's Anthony. Now I'm borrowing my friend's phone because mine died.
Uh-huh.
Have you thought about the movie at all?
Nope.
I told you about this weeks ago.
I've written some notes down, but
nothing concrete.
Well, keep thinking away. This can work out.
If we condense the scenes enough, it'll only take 2 or 3 trips for you to take up here.
What?
2 or 3 trips.
Yeah, I'm not driving 3 hours up to that f**hole.
It's 2. Don't exaggerate.
It's a waste of time and gas money.
You know, there's plenty of f**ked up shit down here for you to film.
It's Albany TV. No one cares about f**king Blauville.
There's lots of crazy shit that you can play around with.
Well, it's too muddy to start a narrative around it.
You know what? You're a fucking dick.
It's only logical. Albany TV for Albany students.
Yeah, how about you go fuck yourself?
Well, all right, you keep thinking and I'll keep thinking and we'll work it out. We still have the rest of break to figure it out, okay? All right, bye. ATV hired me to make the first movie for their television station. That should be pretty exciting. Me and him have been talking this break about what we want to do with it, how should it be shot, what the subject of the film is going to be, and we're kind of at a loss right now. We really don't know what to make. Thankfully, we don't have to shoot anything until spring, so this gives us some time to kind of sit, relax, and think about it. And hopefully after a month or so, it'll all kind of form itself together into a nice little package. I'd like to think that I'm the master of my own design. Everything in life that I kind of have around me, I am in one shape or another, can handle, you know, kind of pulling the strings, I'd like to say, a little bit.
Tim, I need your help. We're filming this movie for Albany, and everyone's being a fucking asshole, and no one is getting anything done, and I just, please, will you be in the movie? I just need you to do a small role, just a few lines, and that's it.
Nah.
Why not? Yeah.
Hey, John. I think I have an idea for how to do the movie.
why don't we do it over break so that it doesn't interfere with my classes and it...
Well, I guess it wouldn't affect you either way.
Sounds interesting.
After I come down for Christmas and New Year's, I can spend the rest of the time shooting the movie. That way, they John, Sierra, and all those other stations can't have anything on us. Go by our own rules.
That's what I'm talking about.
So I was kind of thinking, you start it.
I knew there would be some f***ing catch to this shit.
Just because I was starting to like you.
Hey, meet me halfway. I come down to you, but you play the biggest part.
Fine. Send me the email and I'll cast everyone you need in their respective parts.
Okay.
You know, while you're at it, why don't you open up a f***ing concession stand that
exclusively sells sandwiches named after your favorite things, like Godfather sandwich.
The fake pleasant demeanor sandwich. The dragging John into lots of f***ing awful shit that he doesn't want to be involved in sandwich. Or my personal favorite, the...
Your mother sandwich, packed with lots of meat, thumb sauce, and all other sorts of f***ed up slutty shit. And not only would no one ever
admit they were involved in doing, and then put it out in your free f***ing appetizer sandwich so everyone can take a f***ing try of it. How about that? So in another successful plot to make us all f***ing miserable, Anthony's decided that we should only have a week to film this entire movie. He's got school, okay, and work, so that only gives us a week. The movie we're filming is called Ice Pick. It's about a serial killer who kills people with an ice pick. It's f***ing clever, right? Anyway, my character, I'm the hero, his name is Chris. He's kind of a bitch, kind of just s*** his pants and cries whenever anything stressful happens. Anthony's character, his name is Jimmy Conway. Has nothing to do with him wanting to be Robert De Niro. He's a serial killer, kind of clean cut, kind of a Norman Bates, Ted Bundy kind of guy. I always thought Anthony, you know, kind of acted a little bit like Ted Bundy. And what he does is he domineers the entire f***ing movie. As you know, Anthony's got a power fetish. And even on the hero, it kind of just takes me along with him and forces me to be an accomplice to all of his murders. As he kills his family, his friends, and his girlfriend. Then at the very end, I don't even do anything about it. He kind of just stabs himself in the stomach and dies. I'm f***ing useless. Evil really wins. Kind of just extinguishes itself.
This Christmas is going to be nice. This Christmas is going to be nice. Hey, Mom, what's up? Yeah, no, I just sent Mama Hayes' letters in the mail a couple days ago. Why? What's up? How long she's been in there for?
Sadly, there's been a death in the family, so he's got to stay at his grandmother's for a few days, and it only gives us 3 actual days to film the movie. I don't know how we're going to f***ing do that, especially when you consider that we're working with a lot of jackasses. I'm going to f***ing kill myself.
All right, Jalen, I should be back by the end of the week. I'm going to give you the keys. Just so we don't have any vagrants, any mishaps here at the house.
Just please don't invite anybody weird or anything. But obviously, the room's all yours, bathroom, utilities, everything you need.
All right, got
thank you very much, man. I'll see you at the end of the week.
Yep.
So Anthony's going to be coming down soon, and I've been charged with setting up the movie on my end here by inviting people over for the big party scene where my character Chris is throwing a party at my house. We're going to have lots of people come over, and Jermaine invites Anthony's character, who's almost as creepy as he is, and he comes on over, and I'm not really okay with it because, you know, Anthony tends to be really conspicuous during parties. Like, overly conspicuous. Anthony's very big on that big Italian, hey, I'm gonna feed you, you better love me kind of thing. It's his way of paying people, I guess, that cheap son of a bitch. Hey, here you go, here's some of John's soup that he made. I think this movie's gonna be alright, you know? It's gonna be distracting.
Hey, what's up?
Nothing much.
Where the f*** is everyone else at?
You forgot to invite everybody else, didn't you?
Yes, I did. At least I got some soup on the boil.
What the hell is this? This is boiling water with a f***ing rock in it.
Yep.
Well, you do realize it's gonna taste f***ing awful. You got anything to add in it? You got any rice?
Yeah, in the cabinet.
See, this will have a little bit of weight.
So, how you doing?
Okay. You know, I'm, okay.
Yeah. Good. Where's your button-down shirt?
Oh, I forgot it. Oh, left it in my house.
So you also didn't shave and your hair's rather untidy.
F*** you, John.
Well, I guess we'll just have to work around it then.
Is anybody here?
Yeah, Jermaine's here.
Yeah, Jermaine, how's it going, bud?
What's going on, man?
Is there anybody else here?
No, there is no one else here.
Oh, Jesus Christ!
How the fuck can you forget such an integral detail?
Hey, you fucked up too.
I have an excuse. What's yours?
Guys, I had important stuff to do.
You do nothing!
Yeah, and that always takes top priority.
Assholes!
What?
Just work it into the fucking story.
So Anthony, since you have to rewrite this scene, why don't you give us the pages for the next one? You know, the murder one?
I didn't write that yet either. Can I borrow some pen and paper?
So Anthony's down in Rockland again. John tells me that he's here to film some shit, some like movie or something like that for Albany TV network. I don't know shit about cameras, but I don't know, I just wanted to stop by and see what it was all about.
Action.
Oh god. Then it's just Jimmy.
Dude, why do you hate Jimmy so much?
Because he's a nut job?
Nah, he's mad cool, man. He gets us whatever we want.
That's only because he's looking for acceptance.
What's up, guys?
What the fuck, Ray?
God damn it.
I'm sorry.
You ruined the take.
Asshole.
Cool beans.
Go over there and sit in the fucking corner.
You go over there and sit in the fucking corner.
Get out, you're ruining my take. Just go. Alright? Right over there.
Fucking
yeah. Jesus Christ.
Fucking all of you.
I'll be my trailer.
Fuck this.
Action.
Really? Alright. See you later. Well, Tom and Dennis aren't coming.
Oh god. Then it's just Jimmy.
Dude, why do you hate Jimmy so much?
Because he's a nut job?
Nah, he's mad chill, man. He gives us whatever we want.
That's only because he's looking for acceptance.
Surprise. So right now they're setting up the murder scene. They're gonna skip the crime and just go straight to the aftermath. Kind of like Reservoir Dogs. And I don't know, I made that reference, that similarity. I pointed it out to Anthony. And he started going f***ing nuts. He was yelling at me, threatening my mother, telling me about this lost art of subtlety and how Hitchcock would roll over in his grave. Personally, I don't think this guy knows his ass from his elbow about subtlety.
F*** you, Ray. Suck my dick.
Stupid f***ing thing.
Do you know I can hold a camera?
Shut up, Ray.
So basically you're dead like a possum.
Easy enough.
Alright, John, do you have the ice pick? Is it upstairs? Where is it?
I kind of forgot to buy it.
God damn it, John. God damn it.
Yeah, I kind of dropped the ball there.
You're a fuck up.
Isn't that the pot calling for getting black?
Why don't you guys just suggest it?
Excuse me?
Stand in front of the body, where the ice pick would be, so the camera can't see it. And then, at a later time, just go buy one.
That's some good thinking. You found him like this?
I just turned him over.
Do you have any idea how this happened?
No idea.
Could he have done it himself?
Notice how the fucking black guy's gotta be the one to die? Fucking assholes. God damn it. Racist pricks.
At this point, Jimmy has killed Jane and is now going after Chris. Should be interesting.
So, For this last scene, I really wanted to go all out. I haven't told John yet, but I'm gonna cut him in this scene, just so that his character feels some nice raw emotion for the most climactic part of the movie. It'll be great.
Raw emotion? What the f*** is your problem? You're gonna cut him?
Risk is our business. Besides, it'll look good.
So for the next shot, can we get you in the mirror, at the sink, me in the doorway, without a reflection of the camera or tripod?
No. Tripod's too short.
What if we pulled it back?
Then we lose you.
Let's give it a Ray.
Really?
Ray.
Yeah.
Do you want to hold the camera?
Sure thing.
Put it in your hand, and the hand that's not holding the camera, squeeze your wrist so you stay as steady as possible.
You got it.
I guess that just leaves you and me.
We finally finished filming. It's taken the entire day. But I'm happy. I'm happy with how everything turned out. We're gonna wait until the studio opens at Albany.
That bastard actually f***ing cut me.
We're gonna cut everything. It's gonna be alright.
It is the biggest piece of shit I have ever seen in my entire life. Everyone who acted in it sucked ass. I haven't slept in 3 days. I'm now bleeding from my f***ing arm because some f***ing lunatic decided to stab me.
It's gonna be alright. Pioneers.
Chris?
What's up, Kelly?
What are you doing up here?
I got a job interview.
It's nice. That's nice.
Listen, nah, I'm sorry about your loss. I just heard.
Thank you, Chris. But what about the job?
It's like a job at PacSun. It's like a minimum wage kind of thing, but it's like whatever.
No, that's great. That's a start. What's it entail?
It's like your typical, like, what's up, dude? Welcome to PacSun. Come buy our shit. Like, you know, it's like
kind of douchey.
Kind of douchey, but like, I'm not a douchebag, so like, that's the angle I'm going at.
Ah, but aren't you now?
So what's up?
Nothing.
Take that.
What's this?
Kelly, there are things a man will tell his bartender that he would never tell his doctor.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Of course I'm right. What's up?
I've just been thinking, you know, things I am doing, things I ought to be doing, things I should be doing.
Like what?
Everything. I mean, it's boundless. There's no reason I couldn't succeed.
And that goes for everybody. Everybody feel like could just do everything. Potential for it, you know, it's in our reach.
Quite the grasp, Mr. Kelly.
But to seize it, that's the big question. You know, whether it be the academics, extracurricular, even this little film thing that I did over the break, it's not everything.
Like what?
Bigger.